In this topic, we are going to discuss about the solid dielectrical material. Okay, so first we'll go for the what are we have. Okay, what are the insulating material we have? So here in the solid and liquid dielectric. So in the previous session we have discussed about the liquid insulating material. Okay, now we are going to discuss about the solid dielectric. Okay, so here we are having the classification of solid insulating material. So we have on the organic solid material, okay, inorganic solid material, composite insulating material, okay, nanocomposite dielectric, right? So here in this what are we having this solid insulating material? So this insulating material which we are using, that is we having the different types. One is we having the insulating materials, that is we having, okay. So in the organic solid material, okay, so we having the polymer organic material. Okay, in that one we have again two types, that is thermoplastic and thermoset polymer. Okay, so these are having the height. Yes, tell me. Now, so we having the types, right? So in this type we having the different types of the solid insulating material. Okay, so we having the mainly we having types which consider, okay, organic and inorganic. Okay, so inorganic solid material, so we have what we having the, so in inorganic material, okay, that we having the ceramic insulator. Okay, it's nothing but porcelain material which are using. Okay, next glass insulating material. So mainly we have seen these two types of insulating material in electrical system. Okay, so mostly seeing that is insulating material, that is which having that, okay, I think you have seen this one. Okay, so ceramic insulating materials are which I have seen in the most, okay, compared to the glass insulating material. And so ceramic insulating material which I am using, okay, that we having the most effective, okay, compared to other. So because it is the cheap material, okay, ceramic insulating material which you using, that is a cheap material. That's why we are using the mostly, okay. And one other thing is that, so ceramic materials which are being there, that is the weight, okay, it will consistently more weight comparing to that, okay. So that's why in the, okay, it will be available economically for our transmission system, distribution system, okay. Here at that insulating material, okay, as insulating material, so where we are using as ceramic material as insulating material in electrical system means, if you consider the transmission system, okay, first we'll talk about the transmission system. In the transmission system, so to hold the belt, okay, to hold the conductor, so we are using the disc insulator. So string insulator, disc insulator, different. So in this one, so mainly is that ceramic materials are mostly used because it is a cheap material comparing to the poly. But so it will consist in the more weight, okay, it having the more weight. So that will having the, so the property of nature. So here one disadvantage that, so it will having the weight more, okay, and if it is any occur is there, so if breakdown is occur, what will happen, we have to replace the total, okay. So that's what they do. So they are doing the material which are using ceramic material, they are using the for different strings, okay, so not compostable. So that, okay, ceramic metal, so we are using this single disc type, right? That's why we are using the single disc type. So if any puncture is occurred, that is nothing but if it is breakdown is occurred in the insulating material, that is called as a puncture. So if this puncture is occurred, that is a breakdown is occurred in the insulating, so what we have to, so we have to remove the total equipment, okay, that's the thing. And if we talk about the solid, okay, as compared with the liquid and gaseous dielectrical material. So if we consider the liquid dielectrical material, okay, so liquid dielectrical material, what will do? So liquid dielectrical material having the different, right? So in the liquids, what having, So liquid dielectric metal having whatever the dielectric strength is there, okay, if it is any breakdown occur, what happens? It will regain the that dielectric strength partial. Okay, it will regain the that dielectric strength partial. As well as coming to the gases, okay. So if you coming to the gases, what will happen? So if it is any breakdown is occur, okay. So if it is breakdown occurred in the gases, what do you do? So here, so it will regain back their dielectric strength. Okay, the breakdown strength will be regained. But here, so if it is, we can regain the dielectric strength in the gases and partially regain in the liquid. But coming to this solid liquid one, okay, solid insulating, what they do? So if we break down any is occurred, that have to, so total it will loses it their dielectric strength, right? So here that's the point, right? So coming to the liquid dielectric metal, if the breakdown occur, it will regain their properties partially. If in the gaseous insulating material, if the breakdown occur, it will regain their breakdown strength completely, okay. But coming to the solid insulating material, if it is breakdown occur, so we have to replace with another, that way it will lose the total but dielectric strength, okay. That is the thing. So here we have it. So ceramic also there, right? If it is ceramic insulating material used in a transmission line, what happen if it is breakdown is occur? So we end the if it is breakdown, so what happen? It will be fractured, right? So what will happen? We have, if it is any voltages, high voltages applied, so what to, it will act as a conductor, right? It will act as a conductor. So for this reason, what you have to, so whichever will having the highest max, highest strength, okay, that we have to use. Now if coming to the, we have to, right? So in the, these are the inorganic solid, right? We have the ceramic and glass insulating, okay. So both are having this, but compared to this ceramic, so glass is having the less, and breakdown strength of the ceramic material compared to the glass, okay, is less. So glass is having, so that's why in only special cases only we are using the glass insulating material. Okay. Now coming to the organic solid material, okay, in the organic solid material, so what we having the, so we having the polymer organic material. So in the polymer organic material, so which type of the insulating material? So we having the, again two types, that is thermoplastic and thermoset plastic. So this polymer, it's a combination, okay, composite material. So it will having the, mainly it consider it having the thermoplastic and thermoset. So if you consider the transmission lines and distribution lines, so nowadays they are going to using the this polymer material. Why? Because if coming to the ceramic material, so what happen if it is any breakdown is occur, what have to, we have to replace the that material, okay. So let us suppose in the distribution system, so in the distribution system we are having the pin insulator, right? So if the pin insulator is failed, okay, if it is a ceramic material, what have to do, we have to replace it. If it not replace one, what will happen, it will be act as a conductive medium and it will continuously flow through the faults, okay. That's thing. Next, if you come, if you use the polymer material, so what happen, it will having the highest break, okay. So compared to the ceramic and glass, so it having the breakdown is high, okay. The breakdown voltage for polymer material is high. So if you use as a polymer material as a pin insulator, what happens? So the breakdown strength will have, okay. So one thing is that, so here polymer material, okay, this polymer material does not affect by the temperature, okay, and moisture content in the atmosphere. So if temperature, moisture content, that will be affect the ceramic. So if it's temperature high, so pressure is high, electrical field pressure is high, what will happen, it will easily break down the ceramic material. If coming to the polymer, so the breakdown is high, the it will not affect the moisture, it will not affect it by the temperature, that's why. So it will compare to the weight, so ceramic material having the highest weight and polymer having the light, so we can easily move on that, okay. So as well as that, So compared to the ceramic and glass, so polymer having the less weight. That's why we are using the mostly in the 11 kV and 33 kV that we are going to use in the polymer. Okay, so for less, for domestic sorry distribution system, that is economical, because if you are using in a transmission system, so they are using ceramic and glass membrane because it having the less cost compared to the polymer at that transmission. But in the distribution system, it is the economical because the cost effective, the material required is also less in the distribution. That's why they are using the polymer material in the distribution system. Okay, having the two types. So based upon the application, based upon the requirement, okay, so based upon the area where we are using, that will be different. Now coming to the another thing is that composite insulating system. So we have any different types of composite material, that is we are combined with the polymers, okay, so composite insulating. So in the composite insulating materials, so manaki different, so polymers tho varakunda, so different, so polymers kante kodiga, so vitini endante here these material which are using composite insulating material. So we will use it for the for special application, that is wherever highest strength of the highest voltages. Okay, so coming to the laboratory purpose, that we are using the, so composite, as well as if we take the for space, so in the space applications, in the space application, composite and nano composite material are mainly used for as a solid insulating, because they have to withstand the different temperatures as well as different atmosphere condition. So these are mostly used in this space research. Okay, so that's why we are not using in this both type in practical, that is a transmission distribution system. So nano composite dielectric mainly used in the space research, because the dielectric strength, the weight, the less weight, okay, is it's very good compared to the polymers and ceramic. Okay, so because here, so if you take, if you use this nano composite dielectric and composite insulating, so what happened in the present scenario, that is a transmission distance, so it will not suitable for this type of temperatures and atmosphere. So it will be used for space researching because the cost. Okay, so one thing is that, so if you use the transmission system, so what happens, the cost will be high. Okay, the insulating material cost will be high. Okay, the economic, okay, the economic also will be compared to that. So first thing is cost. So cost effective, that's why we are using the mainly the cost effective, that's why we are using the inorganic solid material in the transmission system. Okay, if it is having the economical, okay, they having the distribution system, what we are using the polymer organic materials are used. Okay, so in the space research, in advanced research laboratory, so we are then using the composite insulating material. So space research, that mainly using the, that is the nano composite dielectric. Okay, so less weight, first thing is the less weight and easy to combine. Okay, that's it. So these are the classification of the solid insulating material. So let me talk about the, so how breakdown is occurred in the solid dielectric. So okay students, let's see the screen. So in the screen you can see, so breakdown mechanism can be classified. So how the breakdown is classified in the solid dielectric, so we have the types, that is intrinsic or ionic breakdown. Okay, next we have the electromechanical breakdown, next failure due to the drain and rotting, next thermal breakdown, electrochemical breakdown, and breakdown due to internal discharge. So we have these different types in the solid insulating material, that is we having the intrinsic or ionic breakdown, electromechanical breakdown, failure due to the drain and cracking, next thermal breakdown,
electrochemical breakdown due to internal reaction. Let's talk about the ionic breakdown or intrinsic breakdown. Okay, so intrinsic breakdown, what happened? So here first thing is that it will be affected due to the atmosphere conditions or temperature. Okay, this will be. So here this breakdown, so why the breakdown is occur? Okay, let me talk about these are the types of the breakdown. Now if we talk about the why breakdown is occurred in the solid insulating material, so first thing is that, so here it will affect it. So one thing we can say that will having the so called temperature. Okay, so it will be affected the temperature. Next, high voltage. Okay, so whatever the highest field of the temperature there, okay, that will another thing. So high voltage, which voltage we are applying, okay, that is the thing. Next, temperature variation around the dielectric material. Next, and surface area. So how surface area of the dielectric material is there? So if it is having the dust particles, any in particles, okay, any unwanted particles in the dielectric material also, it will causes the breakdown and moisture content. So if it is moisture content, so if it is moisture content is high in the material, okay, that will also cause of the breakdown itself. So because if moisture is contained there, so it will causes in the breakdown. That is, it will affect it to the high voltages. So due to the high voltage, the current will be flowed to the solid insulating, that will cause the breakdown. Next thing that aging. So due to aging also is there. So do the material which having the aging effect, that is having the, so it may be consisting the, so it will be using the throughout the years, that one thing. So it will having some age effect. Because if aging effect also one of the main cause in the breakdown occurs in the transmission line issue. So due to that, so in the every 6 months or 1 year, what they do, so they will check all the transmission system. So when we are there, okay, so maintenance will be done. So in the transmission and distribution, in the maintenance will be there. So that will maintain the total transmission line. So where the distribution line, transmission line, okay, the maintenance will be done in the throughout the, so every in the quarterly or half yearly they will do. Okay, because if it is if it not done maintenance properly, so what they happen, so it will goes to break. That so funds we having thing, that is the, so one thing is the temperature, high voltage, surface and moisture and air. So main thing is have the thing. Okay, so one thing is temperature, high voltage applied and surface area of the solid material and moisture content and aging. So these will affected the mainly in breakdown failures. Okay, brain occur chances in the solid material. Okay, so here intrinsic material, electromechanical breakdown, failure due to the tearing and dragging, okay, thermal breakdown, electrochemical breakdown, breakdown due to internal. So these are the types. So what we have tilt, okay, that is temperature, right? So these are all coming to the NS. So why, at what state, okay, if it coming to the intrinsic, at what condition the breakdown occurs? Okay, if it coming to the tearing and dragging, so at how tearing and dragging we have there. So at what cost, okay, so this will be appear. Okay, that, so thermal, so it will thermal breakdown in the high voltage pressures on the dielectric. Okay, that is it, right? So electrical, so electrochemical due to the atmosphere condition, any rain, so thermal variations, atmosphere variations, okay, that's all. And breakdown due to the internal, that is the main thing, is a breakdown due to internal itself. That's the first thing, is that aging, okay, and moisture content also is take places while going to the breakdown. So these are the topics of the breakdown occurring in the solid dielectric material.